All right, we're back! And you fellas are on the air. How's that chair coming for you?
Will you tell him to stop breathing down my neck?
I'm not breathing down your neck. I'm trying to read you the instructions. Remove all parts from the kit box and remove all plastic covers from the parts. Separate and organize in different pieces of the chair so you can find them all, and that's step one. I don't see what I'm doing so wrong.
Will you just sit down over there, please? You're driving me crazy.
Well, did you do that?
Well, before you read the instructions, maybe you ought to tell me what I need. On the list?
Oh, yes. You need the office chair kit, the boxer, and you need a 12mm open-end wrench.
A 12mm open-end wrench.
Well, I'm sure we can find that somewhere,
seeing as you are a surgeon, doctor.
All I have is this closed-ended one. That will be just fine.
All right, let's start, shall we?
Give me the box. See, Johnny, it's really very simple.
If it's so simple, why are you standing on my hand?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ah! All right, what's step number two?
Did you do step number one? You don't want to get... Oh, I see. Okay.
Use the four included screw-head bolts to connect the aluminum receiver on top of the bottom of the set piece. Make sure to get them extra tight as they are not self-locking bolts.
These?
What's not a self-locking bolt? Tell me what's next.
Slide the elbow tongue into the receiver of the bottom of the seat piece. Then bolt the top piece onto the back piece using the two shorter screw-head bolts and the plastic receiver, including the tip. See, the aluminum receiver is on the bottom of the set piece, and now you put it on the top.
Really quite. If you say it's really simple, one more time. All right, what's number four?
Have you done all that already?
No, I haven't done it already. I'm not nearly ready for step number four. I just love hearing you chatter on and on and on aimlessly.
So I should go wait?
You should get over here and tell me what step number four is. You're in my light. You're still in my light.
Clip all the wheels onto the legs. This may require an extensive...
Listen, there's one thing you should know as we go on here. I don't really care what they have to say about it. I just want to know the instructions. What to do. Not what they think it should do. Not what they think is going to happen. I don't want to hear about elbow room. You're in my light again. Just continue.
You will know when the wheels are secured when they clip them to the bottom.
Johnny.
What?
Johnny.
What?
Did they, you know?
Did they click into place?
They said you were supposed to see if they clicked into place, but I didn't want to tell you because... I need to sit down.
Don't you dare sit down on a job. Get over here. What's number five?
Did they click?
Yes, they clicked! They clicked! Didn't you hear it? Give me that. We're gonna die waiting for you to read this. Place the plastic spindle cover over the neck of the chair. It should slide easily down into place.
Is that their professional opinion? Or maybe I can...
Don't touch it. If you just get out of here, that would help.
You call me away, you send me back. I don't know what to do with myself.
Read number six.
Are you ready?
Of course I'm ready!
Slide the neck into the base legs of the chair. Johnny, please, the other neck. Again, press hard to make sure the piece is very secure.
Can you stop fiddling with your tie? Will you go sit down? Don't look at me like that. Will you get back here? I need you.
I always don't start that.
The last one here, it says, is twist the top of the chair onto the neck piece until it is secure.
The chair.
And make sure not to cross the thread and piece them. Cross thread? This isn't sewing, it's a chair. Why is it cross thread?
Here, wait, Johnny. Here, look. Don't get excited. Here are the tips and warnings.
The tips and warnings. I put this thing together and now he tells me the tips and warnings.
Can I please?
No, you cannot please. I don't want to hear the tips and warnings now. What good are the tips and warnings now?
But the next time you make a chair, you'll know, right? You're not going to. Okay.
For all those who wanted to know what the tips and warnings were, give yourself a nice open space to work in so you won't lose parts or bump into other objects.
You're in
always
my
be careful of pinch points when working with chairs.
Will you just sit down? Will you go sit down?
Like when you get your fingers.
You sit down? Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Oh, Johnny, you're bleeding. Look at the finger. Look at your blood. I can't take it. I don't do well around blood.
Well, you're a surgeon.
When we come back,
we are going to be talking on a car phone with somebody that you should like. So without further ado, I take you to an all-night gas station somewhere near Denver, Colorado.
Did you get the bags?
No, but Johnny, look what I found. This poor little dog must have lost his way.
Put it in the bag and let's get going.
Johnny, don't be cruel. He's lost.
So are you.
Did you find any maps in there?
Don't be like that.
Don't be like what? Get out of my way, please.
Yes, it just so happens that they had a whole stand for Denver, Colorado. Probably because we're close.
You have the map upside down?
Is that why all the roads are coming towards me?
Could you turn it around, please, and tell me where we are?
Not too far.
Not too far from what?
Not too far from where I'm standing right now.
On the map, you nut! Oh, yes, we're right there.
Where?
In Arvada. Please don't burst into song.
No, not Nirvana. Arvada. See, it's one more turn to Wadsworth Bypass.
Wadsworth Bypass. What is this, Kennywood?
Which, if I'm correct, will lead us all the way down the South Road to Lakewood.
Well, what's the next closest thing out of our way?
Yale Avenue.
Good, maybe you can pick up a thing or two.
Where are you going?
To get the bags.
Watch the dog there.
For heaven's sake.
That's a good girl.
Wait, Johnny!
No!
Johnny, I have something I need to say to you.
What?
I need to talk to you. Come here.
No, thanks.
No, Johnny, please.
All right. Make it fast.
Well? You called me back here. What did you want?
Would you care for a peanut?
Does it look like I care? Does it look like I care about anything? Will you just get out of my way and let me get the bags?
Wait, Johnny. There's something on your back.
What, you? Hold still, will you? I'm trying to get it off. Unless it's an 8-foot tarantula, I really don't have the time.
This is so strange. It's like attached to you. Hey, Johnny, maybe it's a spike from that desert bush we ran over at 100 miles an hour.
Will you just get it off?
There we are, good as new. Are you sure you wouldn't care for a peanut?
Will you get out of here with those peanuts and get out of my way?
Wait, Johnny, let me check the time.
Oh, it's getting late. We better get out of here before the police catch up with us.
You think?
Yes, I do. It's nearly midnight. Just keep reminding me. I don't think my blood pressure is quite high enough.
Well, don't you think one of us should go get the bags?
The thought had occurred to me.
Well, it's getting dark.
Maybe you should go ahead and I'll stay here in the car and put Phoebe in the back.
No, I have a better idea. Phoebe can ride in the front seat and you can go in the trunk.
Phoebe?
That's what I decided to name her.
You can't be naming things right now. Who has the time?
I do. It's about 10 to 12.
Oh, Johnny, please. I'll get the bags. Don't get excited.
That's more like it.
Keep the engine running.
But only if you were going to anyway.
That's right. And hurry up.
He's the slowest person in the world.
I don't know why you want him for an owner. You'd never be fed.
Jeez,
what now? What's the matter?
What cop speed is here?
What about props?
The cops, Johnny, the cops.
But ditch the peanuts and get in the car.
My entire life flashed beside my eyes.
Short trip. Did you get the bags?
Thanks for listening. See you next time.
What would I need this for now?
But if you have to shave in the car late at night,
why would I shave in the car?
But hopefully not so late.
If we can't find a hotel, you know. Oh, yes. We're invited to so many dinner parties out here in the middle of nowhere that
I think it's called a hatchet.
Don't you argue with me about the plight of the American Indian.
Will you pay attention here? We haven't got all day.
I'm sorry, Johnny.
That's good. Will you open the door?
Awful dark in here.
Tell me about it. Now start looking behind those boxes.
Oh, Johnny, I think I feel faint.
So?
So, I think I feel faint, so I think I need to rest.
There'll be plenty of time to rest in jail if you don't get a move on.
That reminds me.
What?
What?
Whatever happened to Mr. Spinoza?
One catastrophe at a time, please.
I said I was sorry, and yet you're still saying it.
One minute it was there, and the next it was gone.
Will you try and show a little respect?
It has a name, you know.
God, I think my brother could have cleaned up this joint a little better in the last 100 years.
Well, you know those old ladies have sore feet, and they can't get around like they used to.
What are you, their doctor now?
No, but I just... Johnny, I found it!
Really? But where? What?
Your old family album.
Look at all these pictures.
You're a big baby, Johnny.
Come to think of it, you still are.
I'll go look over by the window.
Yeah, you do that.
I don't look by the window.
Hey, look, I found it!
What, did you find it?
No, I just wanted you to know what it feels like.
Must you scream and shout at me all the time?
Yes, I must. It's part of my charm.
Now hand me that flashlight.
Why? Thought I'd beat you over the head with it.
I want to see something.
Here you go.
I don't see anything back there. Check the closets.
I don't really think...
Will you go check the closets? Will you man up just once and go over there and check the closets?
All right.
Yeah, gee, why rush, huh? Let's live up here. Let's send the rats down to the kitchen for some cheese.
Hey, Johnny, how do I look?
That's not your color.
I hate these stupid glasses. I can't see a thing.
You're the one that went to the eye doctor, not me.
I had to. One more month and my insurance would have run out.
So, that's no reason to send away for glasses you don't need.
I thought it would be a nice disguise.
Hold it! Don't move your foot!
What?
Well, That could have been it, but I guess we'll never know now, will we?
I'm sorry, Johnny.
If you say I'm sorry one more time.
I'm sorry.
Is that all you do all day?
I'm sorry.
Stop saying I'm sorry. Just go look. It's gotta be here.
Ah, found it.
Ugh. Thank God.
Let me see.
You have to?
Yes.
It's not too badly scratched. I hope you're happy now. Here's your dumb watch.
It's still almost tale's time.
Well, what time is it?
6 o'clock.
We should have left 2 hours ago for Cleveland. Thank you so much.
Can I help it? I have skinny wrists. I've always had skinny wrists, and now that I'm malnutrition from not eating, it just slips off wherever I...
You know what? Just get in the car. Don't look at me. Just get in the car.
Johnny?
What?
I'm sorry.
Will you turn that radio off?
I could, but then I'd miss my favorite program.
If you don't turn that off, you're going to be missing some of your favorite teeth.
All right. There's no need to be cruel.
Haven't we been over my need to be cruel before? Did you bring the bags?
What bags? For shopping? No.
Ugh, this is going to be Colorado all over again.
Are you crying, Johnny? Oh, steam coming out of your ears?
3 guesses. Now let's go get this done.
I wonder where my wallet went.
Couldn't you have wondered that earlier?
I could have, but I hadn't lost it yet, so how would I know when to start wondering?
Will you drop the philosophy and come with me?
Don't rush me. I have to get the list. Here it is.
Let me see.
It has everyone on it that we need to dispose of.
Everyone? This is the wrong list.
Really? I must have grabbed it this morning without my glasses, when I was very tired and I hadn't eaten yet.
Would you like to add a few more excuses to that?
Wait, I feel it in my pocket.
The list, I hope. Grab a cart.
Johnny, what is this seatbelt for?
Enough of your questions. It's for small people.
Small people?
Yes, like you. No, don't get in.
Where should we start?
This will take a little longer with 2 people, a.k.a. you. We should split up. We can cover more ground that way.
You've been watching too many westerns.
And you haven't watched enough lye soap commercials. Go to the produce.
Johnny, I don't want to be alone.
It's a grocery store. It's not going to eat you.
I still don't want to be alone.
You really should have thought of that before you started signing up for illegal activity.
Yes, but your face does look so nice now.
Wait, what does this mean?
Johnny?
I'm looking at chips.
What is it?
What does this mean?
By the pound.
LB? Johnny, this is way more than we need. Maybe you could go to the meat man. Ask him to cut us a smaller slice. That'd be a good idea? Oh, no, wait. You know, on second thought, you should just put it in the cart. All right. Corn, boxed items, juices, cereal. Wait, shouldn't cereal be with boxed items? Ugh, I can't understand this. You want cereal?
I don't know how to answer.
It's very simple. All you say is, yes, I want cereal, or no, I don't want cereal. And then, when we come to the question of what kind, then you can tell me, I want Lucky Charms cereal, or I want Cheerios. We got your Honey Cheerios, we got your... Don't come back here, I'm trying to... Fine, you're getting this.
But that isn't Cheerios at all.
Well, you made me lose my train of thought.
That's okay, Johnny, I'll eat it. Chocolate-covered raisins.
What do we need? Okay, we need milk. Will you go grab that? Don't look at me like that. Yes, I sent you to the last aisle. Yes, we're going to be apart for 5 seconds. Jeez!
No, it's not that. I think I saw a coupon for that.
Oh, really? Floating above your eyes?
Well, there's just one problem.
Oh, God. What? What? What is the problem? What is the problem with going down there and getting some milk? Half off, if possible.
My wallet. I don't have it.
Darn it. I had dish liquid coupons in there.
Really? That would have been very helpful.
This isn't the time to remind me of that. You know what would be a good time to remind me of that? Never. Go get some milk.
Yes, Johnny.
Yes, Johnny.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Hey, I'm here. I'm so sorry, but I have to... Don't you look at me. What, can I get some macaroni and cheese? Does that disturb you? Does that disturb you terribly? I thought not. That's right, get your apple juice and go. It's about time with that milk. Will you come on? This is half.
No, it's not half off.
No, it's skim milk. It's 0.5% or something. Will you please put on your glasses?
I don't wear glasses.
Oh, how nice. So you've just been pawning off everything that you screw up with the fact that you don't wear glasses. Great. Great. Fine, you're getting this too.
But 0.5% with chocolate-covered raisin cereal? It doesn't sound very appetizing. On the other hand, I can learn to like it.
Are we all set for checkout?
I didn't buy the turkey yet.
Well, if you didn't buy it yet, that means we're not ready for checkout. Funny how life works out.
We've been standing here an awful long time.
Thanks for pointing that out.
No, really, Johnny, it's been like an hour.
Well, everyone's here because they're buying Thanksgiving stuff. Johnny, the turkey. Live with your feet.
But what does that mean, live with... I don't understand.
Gentlemen, are you ready to check out now? Oh, no. What did you remember now? I'm sorry, we'll just be a few more years.
I think I didn't lose my wallet at all. I think it was the coupons that I lost.
No, I think I'll just blow the coupons from your belly button. Now come back here. Did you get the turkey? Did you get the turkey?
I got lost.
You got lost. Lost where? Aisle 8 is like 10 feet by 10 inches.
God, I need an aspirin. Who are all you nut jobs? Alive. It's alive? Good God, there was no murder after all. But wait, what about the scream I heard? What? Oh, yeah. My scream. Well, did you tell them, Dr. Einstein? No. Bungle Nose here dropped a pair of pliers, very sharp ones, on my toe, just before putting me under anesthesia. That's why the scream stopped so abruptly. And you, with the umbrella. Who are you?
Just your average detective.
What are you detecting, incompetence?
I said I was sorry, Johnny.
I'll deal with you later.
All right. If you say another word to me, you're gonna be pushing the car with your nose. Pull up here.
What could be the problem? We need fuel, they have it.
I think the car stalled. Oh, God. The car stalled 5 feet from the gas station. All right, you're gonna have to get out.
Get out. I don't want to see your face anymore.
Yes, Johnny. All right, I think we see my problem.
You see your problem? What is it?
I can't push the car when it's parked.
You have to push it.
No, I mean the wheels will move the car.
Oh. Did you put it in park?
Here.
There you go.
Here I go. I take you, Johnny. But just any minute.
You want me to get out and push?
Did you say something?
Yes, I did say something. All right, well, let me get in the driver's. Will you watch
it? Sorry, did I run over something?
No, I'm fine, but it was a near miss. I'm getting in the front seat. All right, we just have to go over there. Just push us. Just push us over there.
That was tough work.
Right over there.
Wait, Johnny, don't get out.
What do you mean, don't get out? I have to get out to kill you.
No, I didn't run over the little bell thing there.
I think we can survive.
But how will they know when we're here?
I think they'll hear your dying screams.
Okay, Johnny, take it easy. Oh, I'm hungry.
Are you ever full?
No, I'm on empty like our car.
That was a pretty terrible joke. All right, can we get some service around here?
I don't think so. We didn't go over the bell.
You shut up about the bell. We need to find somebody here. Oh, wait, there's somebody. Hey. Hey, you. Come here. Yeah, you, come here.
Can I help you?
Yes, maybe. Have you ever stuffed someone in a trunk before?
I said I was sorry.
You're always saying you're sorry. Now go find something for yourself to eat.
Thank you, Johnny. Johnny, what? I don't have any money.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I not give you your allowance this week?
But Johnny, I'm really hungry.
Here, get something for us both. If there's anything worth eating in this town.
You're strangers, aren't you?
Yeah, not half as strange as you. Look, my car needs petrol.
What's that?
My car is on empty. It needs gas.
I can't help you.
Why not? The pump is right there. You're right there. You got arms.
So you? I don't see your arms is particularly broken.
Look, do you work here or not?
I'm not from around here.
I'm from around there.
Around where?
The loony bin?
Them mountains up there.
Oh, mountain folk. Wonderful. Dr. Einstein, get in the car.
But your car is on empty. Oh, were you lying to me?
I would never lie to a man who throws rocks for a living.
You're nuts, but I haven't gotten anything to eat yet.
Yeah, well, let's get out of here before we're the next meal.
All right, but let me just get some peanuts.
No, we're not repeating the peanut incident. Just get in the car.
All right. Should I drive?
No, get out.
What's the matter, stranger? You realize you need me?
That's a frightening prospect. Look, can you just fill up the car, please?
All right, but I'll have to charge you.
Yeah, I expected that.
All right, just as long as we're clear.
Johnny?
Oh, why couldn't you have changed my name every time you changed my face?
Here, I brought you this to
me. What is it now?
Wait, Johnny.
What? Is it an airplane? Is it a cop? Is it a gun? Helicopter? Tyrannosaurus Rex? Why do you do that to me?
Wait.
I need to hit the floor.
You can't hit the floor. It's a dirt road.
It was a joke. Why am I explaining this to you? Why am I taking the time to explain anything to you? Look at you. Look at your face. Look at your uncomprehending face.
What is it? I think we left a little something in the car.
What little something did we leave in the... Oh, boy. All right, listen, you, Hickman.
My name isn't Hickman, sir.
All right, I don't know why that should make you so happy, but, what is your name?
Johnny, don't.
It's me. It's Ernest T.
Ernest T? That doesn't actually sound like such a bad name.
Ernest T. Beth.
Okay, now it sounds like a bad name. All right, look, you, Ernest T. Would you mind just filling the car with gas and not, you know, touching anything else, please? We're in a bit of a rush.
Well, I understand. I'm in a rush, too. I'm a busy person.
Oh, is that so? Some poor cat wandering around with fur on it still?
Yeah. Well, you jizz, but you don't know. I'm really smart. Just
Johnny.
Don't let it show.
Oh, Johnny.
What?
The trunk is open. I can see that. Thanks for panicking me.
Right. You shut the trunk. Try and keep him quiet. All right, look, you, Ernest P. Could you speed this up, please?
Speed it up?
Well, what am I supposed to do?
I've already got that thing going to this thing.
Yeah, that's a start. But could you finish that process, please? We're in a hurry.
You city folk are always in a hurry, city folk.
Do we look like city Actually, I don't know what we look like. Hey, you. Will you go get in the car?
No, not you. You pump the gas, you get in the car.
God, I didn't think two people would be this hard to orchestrate.
Johnny, I'm a bit thirsty now.
That's great.
No, really, I'm dying.
Not yet, you aren't. Sit in the car. Shut up.
If your friend is thirsty, there's soda pop in that cooler.
I think you've done enough already, thank you.
Just trying to help.
Yeah, well, I don't need help from someone who... What is that?
Johnny, bad news.
Yeah, I hear it. All right, listen, trash can. Take that thing out. I'm getting out of here.
You have to pay me for my services.
What services? You haven't done a dang thing this whole time except lean on my car. With that look on your face. Yeah, that's the one. We're getting out of here. No thank you and goodbye.
You know that's a sheriff. And when he finds out that you didn't pay me, he's gonna grab you knives faster than you can say hot dog.
Why would anyone want to say that? Stop leaning on my car, huh? It's a rental.
Johnny, the trunk is open again.
Why don't you say it a little louder, please?
What are we supposed to do?
Gee, I don't know. Let me think. Oh, yeah. Get out of the car and fix it.
Yes, Johnny.
Hey, listen, you don't treat that little fella very well. We don't really like your kind here.
Well, I don't really like your kind near. Stop leaning on my car.
The sheriff won't like your kind either.
No, and I'm sure the sheriff just loves your kind. Probably invites you over to dinner.
As a matter of fact, he did. This last week, that was the best pot roast I ever tasted.
Okay, I've heard enough. Okay, get back in the car, get back in the car, get back in the car. We have to leave.
I'm sorry, my coat got stuck.
Get back in the car. Come on. Get off my car.
All right, I think you don't want to pay me because you don't think I deserve it.
Wow, when did you figure that out? Did the fly in your ear tell you that?
Well, if you just hold tight there for a few minutes, I will deserve it. I'm going to recite you a poem because I'm learning.
To the mind that brought you, it's me, Ernest T.
Gotta get my vocals warmed up. All right. Sometimes I think of Ivory Morris, skipping rope in a black and white gown, painting her nails red and singing in chorus. A dazzling girl, upstairs and down.
Stop. I think I've heard enough. Here is a dime for my troubles. Put the car in gear. We're getting out of here. What's your problem?
The friend is here. I just buy goodbye from Ernest D. Bass. You don't like me now, but it's not gonna last.
I thought you were a nut. I guess there's others in the room. Now what's that light flashing?
I don't know.
Oh wait, I think I have the emergency brake on. You idiot, why do you have that on? Come on, we've been driving this whole way. No wonder we broke down.
But we didn't break down because of the emergency light. I mean, the emergency brake, we broke down because of the gas.
Don't try and make logic to me, you of all people.
Sorry, Johnny, I didn't know.
Wait, it's the four-way flashers. It's not the four-way flashers. That cop car had pulled up a second earlier.
Maybe you would have arrested that strange man.
What, you?
No, the other one.
Don't talk to me right now. Just drive.
Just drive.